Now, one of the very important strands of modern progressivism, the idea of eugenics, who is the figure that comes to mind who embodies this?
I mean, the obvious answer to that, to the question, is Margaret Sanger.
Thank you for coming. I'm Margaret Sanger.
Margaret Sanger is the founder of Planned Parenthood.
Hello.
In the mid-1920s, Margaret Sanger spoke to a group that came to hear her in full regalia.
Eugenics means the release and cultivation of the better racial elements in our society, and the gradual suppression, elimination, and eventual extirpation of defective stocks, those human weeds which threaten the blooming of the finest flowers of American civilization. The most merciful thing that a large family does to one of its infant members is to kill it.
By Sanger's time, techniques of racial elimination like lynching had become taboo within the Democratic Party. And so Sanger pioneered a different approach to bring about a similar result.
How would you describe Margaret Sanger's so-called Negro Project?
The Negro Project was to bring these birth control and other eugenic measures into the black community. She hired black ministers expressly to sell the idea.
We don't want word to go out that we want to exterminate the Negro population. And the minister is the man who can straighten out that idea if it ever occurs to any of their more rebellious members.
Surely today's Democratic Party leaders would repudiate Margaret Sanger.
I admire Margaret Sanger enormously. I am really in awe of her. And there are a lot of lessons that we can learn from her life and from the cause she launched and fought for and sacrificed so greatly.
Good afternoon, this is Autumn.
Hello, Autumn. I'm interested in making a donation today.
Fantastic.
What about abortions for the underprivileged minority groups? Would that be possible? Like the black community, for example?
Certainly.
It is unfortunate that Planned Parenthood has been the object of such a concerted attack.
What would you expect for intact tissue? What sort of compensation? What would make you happy? What would work for you?
I want a Lamborghini. I want a Lamborghini.
I really face trouble with affirmative action, and I don't want my kids being disadvantaged, you know, against black kids. I just had a baby. I want to put it in his name. And we just think, you know, the less black kids out there, the better.
Understandable.
So I'm hoping that this situation will not further undermine the very important services that Planned Parenthood provides.
Hello, this is Sue. May I help you?
Hi, Sue. I'm interested in making a donation. Could I specify that abortion be done, those abortions be done for a particular minority group?
If you wish, you can.
Okay. So, for example, the black community in Tulsa, the abortions will be done specifically for the black community abortions.
Great.
Today, the vast majority of Planned Parenthood clinics are located in our neighborhoods. We were tricked through a slick marketing campaign, but now that that's unraveling, people are saying, wait a minute, they sell baby parts? What happened to my baby?
Standing up and fighting for progressive values.
And the Nazis admired Sanger and actually patterned some of their programs along the lines of things that she suggested.
Yeah, the first people who get wiped out under the Nazis actually aren't the Jews. They're the mentally unfit invalids and all that. They went through the hospitals and they cleaned those guys out.
What happened to Carrie Buck?
Carrie Buck is a tragic and but really important story. Right? Carrie Buck is this young woman that was supposed to be, quote unquote, feeble-minded. They wanted to forcibly sterilize her. Her case went all the way up to the Supreme Court.
Miss, you need to calm down. I need assistance.
Oliver Wendell Holmes says that it's okay to forcibly sterilize this young woman, who wasn't feeble-minded. She read, she was, you know, perfectly competent, certainly didn't deserve to be forcibly sterilized. And he says in this famous damning line, in his opinion, three generations of imbeciles is enough.
No!
Forcibly sterilized, back in those days, meant something. It meant holding this woman down, doing these terrible things to her through the power of the state, simply because the state had this idea of what the population should look like and who should have the right to be able to have children. Tens of thousands of people across the United States were sterilized. The opening video of the Democratic Convention in 2012, government is the one thing we all belong to. No, government belongs to us. We don't belong to it. We are citizens, not subjects. You remember the Life of Julia ad that the Obama administration put out? Every frame begins with the words, "Under President Obama, Julia gets this kind of scholarship and this kind of loan and this kind of promised job." The creepiest sentence in modern American political history was when the Life of Julia ad says, "Under President Obama, Julia decides to have a child." Nowhere in this do you see Julia's family. There are no parents. There's no husband. There are no friends. It's just the state, as personified by Barack Obama, community, churches, synagogues, family, friends, mediating institutions, as the social scientists call them, that give us a sense of order and place in the world. That's what the role of the state is playing. And it was completely contrary to the ideas of the founding of this country. The classical liberal ideas of the founding of this country: the fruits of your labor belong to you. Our rights come from God, not from government. We are citizens, not subjects.
So progressivism is actually progress away from the founding.
Yeah, no, that's right.